on, stand by now.
Okay, start already. Okay, okay, Mr. Lim.
Okay, these are the two technical terms that we have for 1.3. Alright? Chief, how would you explain union of two sets? I want union, I don't want intersection.
Oh.
I want union.
The
A and B. A and B was the example given in the textbook. And it's not the area. Alright? When you talk about area, it's because they're using the Venn diagram. Okay, if I use simple English, it means that everything is in one set. Everything from the other set, everything must come together. Am I right? So everything is inclusive. So I will say, these two words both will come out. In everything, that means all the elements that you see are, or everything inclusive, will be what we call union. Whereas intersection, based on the word intersection, it means that elements that are common.
But I thought yesterday the
okay, so I'm going to use this example. Look here. Try 14 on page 17. There are two sets given here. Am I right? If we are talking about union of C and D, as given in the question, what are we looking out for? What are we looking out for? Yes, we do.
Everything inclusive.
So how would you represent your answer?
Together.
Yes, how together? So, if I were to say list the elements.
C and D.
C and D, right? So, C union D. Union is represented by U. Capital U, what's a small letter U? You don't need to write a tail. Just U. Big capital U. No tail required. Am I supposed to represent my answer like this? I just write everything here, write everything here, then we'll inside. No double. E has been listed. You don't write it again. Okay? Then, so everything that's found in C, it must be found in D. So this will be your final answer. Likewise, the question is phrased, is D a proper subset of C?
Because
say why no?
Everything in D must
be. If D is a proper subset, everything in D must be an element in D. What is the element in D that's not inside C?
K
and Y. So how do you represent this relationship? So I agree, D is not a proper subset. So your answer, how would you explain your answer again?
Since every element in D is not an element in
D. You won't say everything. Every element.
D does not contain elements that C has.
Can you just say that?
D does not contain elements that C has.
D doesn't.
D does not.
Contain elements that C has.
Switch the C and D.
Switch the C and D. I think this is good enough, but I can have a better answer. What would be a better answer? You tell me what are the elements in D, but they are not found in C. That would be better. How do I phrase it? Very simple. K and Y both are in D. Correct? But K and Y, they are not elements of C. Simple, right? No need to write sentence. These two elements are found in D. These two elements are not found in C. Therefore, D cannot be a proper subset of C. I want to use relationship. Yes. Oh, strike. Thank you.
Nice.
Okay? So D is not a proper subset. This is the relationship. Whenever I ask, I explain. Yes. A proper subset of C union D? Yes. All the elements in D are found in C. Correct? So what can we do? E, K, Y, they are all found in C. E, K, Y, they are all found in C. Therefore, D is a proper subset of C. Correct? C as extra element, but I don't need to explain the C as extra, not C union D.